Welcome to the Deliverance Network. I'm hopeful that this second segment of our Christmas special will be another inspiration to help you through the time of labor pains. Really, all of us are living labor pains from the moment we're born to the moment we die, because it's that spiritual climb in our growth and our development and our choice for Christ. But this Christmas, I really want to focus on how we can stay uplifted, stay hope-filled, become filled with love, become more light and love for our neighbor, and allow our neighbor to be light and love for us, because that is the way that Jesus and God often work through other people, in addition to any personal spiritual experiences you have. So this Christmas, I'm really hopeful that you are going to appreciate some of these gifts and these little nuggets of wisdom that we're going to share with you at the Deliverance Network. Well, as we're coming to you from our Christmas special, I wanted to share again an experience that I had, a dream from 2008. We've shared it before, but because the world is such a difficult place right now, I think it really is affecting people's feelings about Christmas. Some people have gone through devastating circumstances. In Canada alone, for instance, we see some of the things that have happened out in BC. And some people, different circumstances this Christmas than what they might have hoped for. And everyone has different events going on throughout their life, sickness, illness, unforeseen circumstances, financial struggle perhaps. We know this year particularly, some people have lost employment due to unforeseen circumstances that don't seem just. And so I wanted to just say God is in the mix in all of this. Even though we may not see or understand why He is allowing some of these things that He is allowing, definitely in the prophetic circles, people are saying that God is bringing things to a culminating point precisely because He's not going to tolerate all this evil for much longer. So I just want to try to give hope and inspiration this Christmas, particularly if you may be struggling, whether it is financial, illness, loneliness, etc. It's definitely been a difficult couple of years. Sometimes the difficult circumstances in our life are the things that lead us to turn towards God when we might not have already. I know myself, you know, when everything is going very well and you have everything you need, you don't think to pray. You don't look for that higher power. I'm not saying it's fantastic, and definitely sin causes suffering. But I just know sometimes we can turn to God in a mighty way arising out of a suffering. And so I want everyone to be aware that these times that we are in are not going to last forever. God has a plan for them. He is bringing it about. It may be a little bit of a bumpy ride, tumultuous circumstances in the future. I'm not going to speak too much about that today as we focus on Christmas. But I know that there is beauty, joy, peace, justice, and restoration in the future. If we read our Bibles, we listen to the prophetic pulse, a lot of people are saying, yes, it's going to be a bit of a tribulation period, but it is the fruit after. And Jesus likened it to labor pains. When a woman is in labor and about to give birth to a child, and I've had six, so I know firsthand, one without an epidural, that was quite something, let me tell you. And the pain and the tumultuousness of it can be quite something to endure, and it does not feel like it's going to be over quickly. Now that I'm on the other side of it as a mom, and my children are definitely getting older, the beauty, you forget the pain. You forget the pain, and you focus on the beauty of that child that's born. And I would really like for us this Christmas season to try to focus on the beauty that we have. Look around you and focus on the things that God has given you. Try not to focus too much on what he has not. Try to be a support for your neighbor. I find that joy begets joy, love begets love, and the giving begets giving. And so we create peace when it comes out of our own hearts through the circles of those around us. And in this dream experience, it was showing me this coming time of this tumultuous dragon upheaval, and that it was going to basically just all collapse in on itself, and the evil was going to be done away with. And all of the prophetic voices are saying the very same thing. This is not going to last, this period we're in. And after it, there's going to arise a beautiful time of restoration, a beautiful time of hope, joy, love, and peace and justice for the people of God. So I really want you to focus on that this Christmas season and see what you can do in your own small circles to be part of peace, joy, love, hope. And that involves divine surrender and trust, especially when things are harder. So I really want you to focus on that this Christmas season. Well, as we're filming this Christmas season and already sharing the information that I did regarding the tumultuous times, but the coming of a peaceful time after that, I want to tie in a recent posting from Countdown to the Kingdom that talks exactly about that. And Mark Mallett had titled it, When Tyranny Ends. And I'm not going to read the whole thing because it's quite a detailed writing, but he really ties together information from a lot of places. I think Mark Mallett is a wonderful reporter, obviously has a background as a television person who was anchoring and broadcasting, so definitely knows his craft and has now been working for the Lord in the vineyard for quite some time. And he's talking in this segment entitled When Tyranny Ends. You can look it up yourself on countdowntothekingdom.com. He's talking about how the books of Isaiah and the prophecy of Isaiah is going to dovetail with the book of Revelation and tie into the times that we're in and the times that are coming. And the reason that I'm bringing this up now, because I definitely don't want to focus on dark and dire at this time of Christmas, but the fact that he brings together Isaiah and Revelation talks about the times coming after the time of struggle that we go through. And it's very much a time of blessing and holiness. And so I want to share this little snippet. It says, so the blessing foretold undoubtedly refers to the time of his kingdom, of course, Christ's kingdom, when the just will rule on rising from the dead, when creation reborn and freed from bondage will yield an abundance of foods of all kinds from the heaven's dew and the fertility of the earth, just as the seniors recall. Those who saw John, the Lord's disciple, tell us that they heard from him how the Lord taught and spoke about these times. And this is a reference to St. Irenaeus of Lyons, church father, and it's reference to 140 to 202 AD. And it's from Adversus Heresus, Irenaeus of Lyons, the fathers of the church, CIMA Publishing. And so when we're talking about the labor pains, they're leading to a birthing. Mark references this as well, and he says, labor pains we are presently enduring are leading to a birthing that will bring about the restoration of the kingdom of Christ. So taught Pope Pius X and his successors. It is the restoration, the kingdom of the divine will within the heart of man that was lost in Adam. Perhaps the resurrection that St. John speaks of before the final judgment. It will be the reign of Jesus Christ, King of all nations, within his church in an all-new manner. When Pope John Paul II, that famous pope of ours, calls a coming new and divine holiness. This is the true meaning of the symbolic millennium anticipated with Christianity, a triumph and Sabbath rest for the people of God. And I really want you to keep that in mind as we struggle and go through all of the tribulations of our life, regardless of the tribulation period we may be in and entering, that there is a purpose to it, a resurrection, the laboring gives birth to a beautiful new period of restoration. Well, rounding out this part two of our Christmas special and the whole talk of labor pains and how we're each laboring in our spiritual journey, really, until our destination, the eternal rest in heaven. And I wanted to share another dream experience with you that I had from 2008, May of 2008. And it talked about a time of labor pains. We're sensing a theme here with part two, the struggle and the labor that gives birth to restoration and rest. And in this dream experience, it was basically God calling me to walk down the streets and be a witness. And here we are, of course, filming 2021 Christmas, and I'm in the street witnessing to you. So a bit of a prophetic dream. And I was walking with God's power in order to be able to witness to the birth of Jesus, to witness to the truth of our faith, to encourage all of those who are in their faith to hold fast to it as we're going through some of the labor pains, and also to look forward to the restoration and the time of rest, especially in this time of joy of Christmas. And in this dream experience, God only uttered two words with me as I walked down the street, proclaiming for God the Father, proclaiming for Jesus, acting as a witness to the experiences that I have personally had of him, and the witness many other people all over the world have been giving to the truth of the faith. And he said two words through me at this time. He said, Yahweh speaks. And when it comes to our faith, oftentimes we do not hear God definitively speak or utter words or have a sure knowledge that this is exactly what he wants. I heard in a video presentation that I was giving to a group of women last night that oftentimes God speaks greatly in silence. He speaks greatly in the circumstances of our lives that unfold. He is allowing things with his permitting will, and you can rest assured that if it's happening according to many, many prophetic voices, that God is allowing it in your life for some great purpose. And again, I would encourage you to spend some time, especially this Christmas, in silence, because God is hard to be heard. The depths are the stirrings of the Holy Spirit in our heart when we're distracted, when we're busy, when we're fearful, when we're rushing around. We often overlook the small inspirations or whispers. And I shared recently a message through holylove.org where God says, I'm constantly guiding you, especially when you're in times of pain. And I have your guardian angel watching over you all the time. At Christmas, there couldn't be a better time to think about our angels. Perhaps an increase in relationship with your guardian angel. Pray to him for assistance. What, give me help in this area that I have need. Because God is always working and never rests when it comes to our salvation. And each person's path is completely and utterly unique. So as you reflect on your life this Christmas 2021, try not to compare yourself to your neighbor's path. Many people, especially younger people, tend to look around and think that they have to emulate what others are doing. But again, when you find Jesus and you seek him, you find a peace the world cannot give, and you find yourself, as Father Hugh Gillespie said. And when you truly rest in Jesus and you rest in yourself, then you really flourish and grow, and you achieve the things that God has planted you on the earth to do, and you are fulfilled and happy because you are you, and you are comfortable in who you are. And Jesus has come to give us life. So I really want you to focus on that this Christmas season. Thank you so much for journeying with us. Thank you so much for joining us here at the Deliverance Network for our Christmas special this year. And I'm really hoping that we have helped you to focus a bit on positive, not on fear, not on all of the darkness that surrounds us. Really, if we truly have Jesus with us, lit up in our own manger of our hearts, we have the warmth and the protection and the love of Christ, the creator of the universe. We have nothing to fear. And in fact, we have the joy the world cannot give. And so I want you to focus especially on that this Christmas with your friends, with your family, and try to focus your light, your heart, your mind, your soul on Jesus in divine trust and surrender, because he's going to lead us through anything we have to face in our lives. No matter how uncertain the future might be, I want you to be thankful, joyful, and focused on Christ, not only now at Christmas, but forever in your spiritual journey until you're with him forever in heaven. God bless. Thanks for joining us at the Deliverance Network, and a Merry Christmas.